Welcome to Sculpture Studios. For this job, Aden travelled up to Manchester and visited the students at the Radclyffe School. Alongside Claire O'Rourke, a teacher at the school who organised the project, Aden talked them through what it's like to own a business, to create a piece of sculpture from concept to completion, and the processes behind it. Ideas were bounced around about what kind of sculpture would best represent the school, with all its values, as well as being an eye-catching piece of art to exhibit. Incorporating all the best designs and collaborating everything together, this sort of giant Olympic flame came out as the final concept. Aden was then entrusted to make this piece as close as possible to the design, whilst having a bit of free rein to ensure it's structurally sound and doing what he can to make it appropriate for exhibition. Aden began by taking a silicone mould of a real hand, as he wanted a 3D model to work from when it comes to blowing it up to full size. So, to work. The hand was designed to sit on a large disc base, so using 8x4 foot boards, we mark out the dimensions and cut the 6.5 foot diameter circle. As there's going to be an unknown but potentially large amount of weight on top of this, it needs to be strong to withstand the force. Here, Aden's cutting out wooden battens to support the structure from underneath. Instead of creating an actual master pattern and then taking a mould from that, we eliminate this step by creating an interior pattern mould that we can take a cast from internally straight away. With the disc cut and a flexible side added, the pattern is ready to be laid into. A release agent and a black gel coat is used, so that if someone ever scratched the black paint that will eventually finish the disc, it will have a black base layer underneath. As with many of our projects here at Sculpture Studios, we're using fiberglass as a strong and durable material to make the base from. We go on with several layers for a really strong build-up, and this strength, as well as supporting the hand sculpture itself, compensates for the fact that the base is going to be at ground level, and is likely to be kicked, hopefully non-intentionally. This is then left to set, and with the help of the release agent, the cast can be extracted from the wooden pattern. Blocking out the hand itself, we're using polystyrene and scaling up to the correct dimensions. We use a hot wire to get a basic cubist form, and then Aden goes ahead and cheese slices the material to create an overall shape of the hand. This is always an enjoyable part of the process for Aden, and it lets him get on with what he does best and what he's always set out to do as a sculptor. Polycarving has always been one of his fortes and preferred mediums for carving large objects like this, and it's nice to create something eye-catching and iconic that people can identify with. He switches to finer and finer tools, nail brushes then wire brushes, and starts honing down on the detail. The cast of the base is released from the wooden mould and the battens are fixed in. All the surfaces are sanded down, repainted and sanded again and again to ensure that we have a really smooth finish. All of these sanding down processes take a long time, but it's a necessary step to produce a decent finish without a solid production mould. For finishing touches on the carving, like the detail of the fingernails, Aden uses stonemason rifflers. There's only really so much detail you can create with polystyrene, depending on the grade, before you need to start sculpting with something like clay, but for large sculptures like this, the level of detail is perfect for the material. Regardless of what we're creating, it's always important for us to refer back to concept images and models like these to ensure that we're on track and we're making what the client really wants. With these miniature versions of the sculpture, a clay flame was actually made to give an impression of how the real thing might look, and Aden then proceeds to carve the top. The client requested that the sculpture was made at a size for maximum impact, however we also needed to make sure it could be transported and still be manageable for our team, and that it could fit through all the doorways on site when we move it to its permanent location in the school. With all this in mind, we measured exactly, ensuring we kept within these specifications. Once the whole piece is carved, it's sanded down and given a protective layer of adhesive stickyback foil. This will protect the polystyrene from the resin, which would just corrode the material if it was applied straight on top. At this stage, we do some final measurements in case any adjustments need to be made, as from this point on, any alterations will be difficult to make once the piece has been fiberglassed. The resin we're using here is Class O rated, which means it's fire retardant, as it's going to be situated inside. The whole piece is given a layer of fiberglass that we're trying to keep really neat so that minimal cleaning up is required. Once the resin has set, the whole piece is sanded and smoothened down, and the sculpture is given an application of a soft plaster filler. This is just regular household filler that you can pick up in tubs from home construction stores. It dries naturally and it's helped along with warmth and a bit of a breeze. This is softer to rub down than car body filler, but for a job of this description, large surface area, inside location so less exposure to the elements, it should be perfect for this job. Here, a logo is being created to adorn the side of the torch. Incorporated in this logo is the letter R, both for the Radclyffe School, as well as representing the five R's that symbolise the school's main ideals of respect. These are sculpted in clay, moulded in silicon rubber, and cast with a different number added to each. The whole process of cleaning up easily takes the longest amount of time for the majority of our work. The sculptures need sanding down, repainting and sanding again and again, until we get the finish we're really after. The flame is positioned on top and permanently joined, as this whole piece is going to be transported in one unit, with only the base that comes separately. Originally we were going to have a seam or a split line where the sculptures could come apart for transport, possibly where the torch meets the hand, but to save on needing to reinforce the sculpture internally with added metalwork, we kept the whole thing in one piece and kept the cost down for the client. When we're happy with the surface, we prepare the sculpture for artwork in. We had a plate made with the Radclyffe School title, and this was to be positioned at the very front of the base. For the purpose of transport and manoeuvrability, we created a fibreglass shell cast straight from the knuckle on the hand. This cushioned around the knuckle would act as a solid resting and tipping point for the sculpture when it's laid down, and protects the points of the knuckle from getting damaged. Aden uses an airbrush to create veins in the white base colour and gives the hand a marble look effect. The title plate is added to the base with its own platform so it can be seen from eye level and easily read. The emblems with the logo are added to the torch and painted in to match the rest of the artwork. The flame is also airbrushed and Aden uses different shades of red, orange and yellow and a touch of white to give it a vibrant look. Before we actually went ahead with the painting, we discussed with Claire what finish might look best for the sculpture. We photoshopped a rendered image when the hand was still in its grey stage to send to her and see what she thought. After confirmation and the go-ahead, here you can see the transition from our photoshopped proposal that we initially sent her to the finished artwork. Suggestions were made about the whole sculpture being artworked in one colour, possibly a bronze or metallic look, but we thought that breaking down the elements and having different colours for the hand, the torch and the flame made the piece more eye-catching and gave it a lot more life. We also thought that seeing as the sculpture is going to be in a school, the children would prefer a brighter and more vibrant piece. Now for the tricky part, the transport. In order to move a large object like this in one section, we made a long trolley with load-bearing caster wheels. We mocked up a frame at our studio and the measurements of the doors that will be on site to ensure that we could get the torch through once we get it on location. As we hoped, our measurements worked out correctly and it should be exactly the same at the other end. We've packed the sculpture with bubble wrap and corrugated board to protect all the surfaces during transport. It's now ready for pickup from our studio for delivery to Manchester. When it came to manoeuvring the sculpture into the school, there weren't any problems with getting it to location. The trolley worked perfectly and it fit through all the doors, and now we're undressing it so Claire can see the sculpture for the first time. We showed her how we protect the piece from getting damaged and gave it an overall check for any possible marks. The base was put in place and then fixed to the floor, and the sculpture was positioned on top. To hold the sculpture to the base, we used a bonding agent and a mastic seal around the edge, and this should provide the sculpture with enough contact and enough suction to prevent it from being tipped over. It's important to keep the job nice and neat at this stage, so that minimal cleaning up is necessary. We make minor repairs to the surface, where the job might have got knocked or scratched during transport, and we add the finishing touches to the artwork. We invite Claire to have a good look around and see the final piece when it's finished. It's always nice for us to get a client's feedback and a reaction at the end of a project, and Claire mentioned that the school might have a few more sculptural opportunities in the future. Whenever we look back, it always seems like a long process from concept to completion, with each job having its own fair share of working out and obstacles throughout the process. Despite this, it's always rewarding for us at the end of the project. To see it finally set up and appreciated by those around it, it's worth the journey, with all its bumps along the way. When the students returned after the weekend, the sculpture was exhibitioned, and the designers got their photo taken with their finished piece. Here they are with Claire, and hopefully they're proud of what they've created. We'd like to thank Claire O'Rourke and the Radclyffe School for allowing us to be part of this, and helping to build part of their school's legacy. We hope the sculpture is situated for many more years to come, and we look forward to any future projects. Please feel free to leave any comments below, as they're always appreciated, and hit the subscribe button for our latest videos. You can like Sculpture Studios on Facebook, and for more of our work, visit sculpturestudios.co.uk. Thank you very much for watching.